Without techniques, we are lost. We're sunk. The ego, at all costs, objects to using any effective technique because it knows that this will free you from insanity. So it will insist on dialogue, on talks, on dialogues, etc. It will not give you any permission to actually use a technique. I've introduced several techniques in these videos, and one of them is the use, it's too late. It's too late for the ego. It's too late for suffering. It's too late for time. It's too late. Super potent technique, actually. I've been using it for weeks now. The other is the spell technique. I used that today, and it was incredibly successful. So by actually utilizing these techniques, you have the escape velocity that is necessary. You'll be able to generate it. Without these techniques, you're sunk. You're going to be sunk because the times now are, they call for technique, practical technique, which just means leverage. It requires potent leverage because the situation is being leveraged against us, meaning against sanity. Insanity is doubling down. It's using all its leverage to try and double down and make sanity admit that it's wrong. And to give up sanity, to give up. So we need powerful, powerful leverage to offset this at this time. And so that's, I've been working constantly to try and, you know, asking, okay, let's have another technique. What's the best leverage we can get right now? I just asked the Holy Spirit, what's the best leverage? Another one came tonight. I haven't tested it out yet. Maybe I'll test it tomorrow. I want to test these out first to see, you know, how effective they are. It's too late is extremely powerful. And the effectiveness of the spell is tremendous. Every time you forget and you feel you've lost your way, just say, wait, I'm wasting time. Why am I wasting time? Under a spell. I must be under a spell. Oh, spell. What's spell? Spell. Oh, remember, it's an acronym. What's the acronym for spell? P is perception. What S? Stable. Stable perception, effortlessly, of effortless, lovely loveliness. Okay. Stable perception of effortless, lovely loveliness. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's what the Holy Spirit provides me. You see, and then instantly you're back in the game. You're no longer off track. Literally at this time, you can tell who is on track and who's struggling to get back on track by those who are able to actually use technique right now and those who cannot yet. They just say, ah, no, that means they're listening to the ego too much. The ego still has too much leverage. Now, this is not a criticism. It's just an observation because for myself, I know I rejected technique for a long, 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 long time. I said, I don't need it. I have the dialogue. That's enough. I have this. It's enough. No, it's not enough anymore. It's not enough anymore. So the whole idea was for us to get to the point at this time in August 2013 where we can actually start using technique. If we're not using technique, we're going to fail. Well, let's just be honest about the situation. The situation is proceeding exactly as it's been shown to me. Exactly. Every time I look at the news, I say, oh my gosh, it's totally according to script. Everything's according to script here. It's like there's some reading of a script. Okay, you do this. Okay, now you do this. And all the actors, they do this. And all the, it's all according to script. So, of course, things are getting exactly terrible the way that I expected them to. So, the leverage that is being used in the world now is just incredibly terrible. So, we have to have even better leverage. Okay, and one of them says to leverage, you're all too late. Too late, you missed me. You missed me. Upset, you missed me. You know? Insanity, you missed me. You're too late. You're too late, you missed me. Insanity was too late for me. Came too late. Insanity, you're too late. Ego, you're too late. And so, you can get into using this and you'll find a tremendous effect if you really can feel it. Let it resonate. So really, the only way to be effective at this time now is technique, through technique. And the wise ones will see that, and those who are capable of it will start doing it. And they'll stop. We have to even stop critiquing what's going on, because it's not going to stop it. Critiquing it won't stop it in the slightest bit. You listen to these people on the news, the radio, the TV, wherever people are talking, and it's just critique, blah blah blah, back and forth, not stopping any of it. It's just a colossal waste of time, and a sure strategy to sink. Whereas if you're saying all this, oh, you're too late. I'm wasting time. Oh yeah, I'm under a spell. Stable perception of effortless, lovely loveliness is the Holy Spirit's gift to us that solves the continuity problem. And what is the inverse of that? Insanity. Insanity. Insanity claims that the way is to make the world a more beautiful place, so we'll want to stay here and call it home forever. Therefore, the ego insanely claims that we've solved the continuity problem because we're never going to go home. That's the ego. That's insanity. That's what runs existence. That's what keeps existence going, is to say, oh, we're going to stay here forever. So there's no continuity problem. What continuity problem? It's miraculously gone. That's insanity. And the world seems to be plausibly sane, okay, but you can tell what's really running someone or the world when the chips are down and the stress is there and a situation's very dire, and you have to, you're going to go to your go-to position. Who's your advisor? Where do you go to? Who do you go to for help in situations where the chips are really down? And most of the people in the world, they go to the ego and go to insanity. And insanity will offer them this magical solution. They say, wow, it's like magic. You know, what an incredible solution. The ego said, don't worry about continuity problem. You're never going home anyway. We're going to make this home, you know, better than reality. So you'll never go home. So there's no need to worry about the continuity problem. And you say, ah, aren't you amazing, ego? You've solved the problem. What a miracle. Of course, it hasn't solved it at all. It's just a complete, utter self-deceit, delusion, insanity. It's just insanity. And the ego basically does a variation on that. On every time you go to the ego for help, it runs a variation on that basic thing, same thing. Whereas the Holy Spirit will say, of course there's a continuity problem, but it's solved. I've solved it by a new mode of perception, a steady perception of effortless, limitless loveliness. That's how the continuity problem is solved. You must go home. You'll never be able to make this world a suitable place, home for yourself. Never. You must go back. You must awaken to reality. You must go back home. You do have a severe continuity problem. But here is the answer to the continuity problem. That's the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit acknowledges the situation factually. The ego refuses to acknowledge the facts of the situation and puts forth an impossible solution that, if it were possible, could logically follow. If it were possible, then some logic could flow from that, but it's not impossible. It's not possible, so the ego's asking you to overlook the facts entirely. And overlooking the facts is insanity. So when the chips are down in this world, people I see they just go right to the ego, say, help me ego, I need a miracle from you. I need some more potent insanity. So let's double down on insanity. And that's the problem with the world right now, is doubling down on insanity, trusting in insanity. That belief that insanity will solve the problem, continuity problem, and then we'll all be in peace and happiness forevermore. And of course, it never goes anything remotely like that. And yet we still listen to the ego and say, offer me up some more potent insanity. It's a habit, and born out of fear, but it's still become a habit for us. So the Holy Spirit says, we must have potent leverage right now. And now, classic spiritual teaching in times when things are really going well, would use various techniques too, mantras, some very powerful tools of focusing that cut through the delay. But those arise out of a certain context. Right now, what I'm seeing is the techniques that I'm giving out. Those work right now. Those are working right now. So the challenge that we have is to actually use these techniques. That's the challenge that we have, and I have been using them. I'm getting better and better and better at it, whereas before I refused to. Of course, the ego is telling me, you know, don't use them. They might work too well. So now they don't work too well. They work well, but not too well. I've not experienced anything. You know, that's anything more than just sort of a slight deep reverberation, as it were, like wow, sort of a slight subtle wow feeling is all. It's not a problem at all. It's not a problem at all. It's like walking on the tee box of some beautiful golf hole. You know, and just like look around and just say wow. I get to play this, this hole. Wow, that's great. But you have this kind of reverberation, like, wow, this is difficult and beautiful. I'm like, it's okay. Get through it. So these techniques give you a certain wow feeling, like, wow, this is really amazing. I mean, it seems to be, you know, doing something, seems to be having an effect. I'm not really sure what, but it certainly does. So from time to time, I've tried to move these videos towards technique, and so far I haven't been able to do it because everyone's procrastinating. You know, they say, no, I just dialogue's good enough for me. It's not going to be good enough going forward. It is not. It is absolutely not. So we have to shift over to technique. Those who say, oh, I just want to talk about it and talk about it and talk about it, are going to be lost. It's getting too tough now. I mean, we knew this time would come, and it is here. It is here. It is here. You know, it is really here. I mean, the cancellation, for instance, of the meeting between the Russian and USA leaders just shows you the battle of leverage that's taking place in the world right now. And there is just an immense, immense struggle taking place in the world. And I've outlined that in many, many, many videos, and it doesn't serve any purpose to just keep outlining it, because it's here. It's not going to go away just because we talk about it. We have to have something that is bigger, transcends it, that leverages us free of the whole, of insanity, free of insanity. Insanity is in control of this planet, is in control of the minds of those animating bodies here. And you have to just say, hey, insanity, you're too late. You don't have a grip on me because you were too late. Got here too late. Sorry, you got here too late. So when you're saying that, you're really saying what I am has already been perfectly established. And so insanity arrived too late to do anything to it whatsoever. You're making that, that's the affirmation you're making. That's the meta message of it. You're too late. You arrived too late. So I understand there's a lot of people who have trouble going from dialogue to the meta message of a condensed shorthand. Really, shorthand is what you might call it. The techniques are like a very wonderful shorthand. So I'm very cognizant of this difficulty, having been through it. But on the other hand, I know it's also essential. So you have that. And I've just found in the world an enormous resistance to a truly effective technique, which means the overall clarity isn't there yet. It's not there yet. It's still not sure, you know, what's going on, and not wanting to tip things in any one direction too much. In other words, not rocking the boat. But the problem is, insanity is rocking the boat and tipping things in its direction too much right now. Way too much. So if you don't want to tip things too much, you're out of luck right now. If you're one of those who says, no, I just, you know, I don't want too much tippage, you're out of luck. Because insanity already has tipped things way too much. It's already happened. It's already happened. And most people bury their head in the sand saying, no, I just deny it. It's happened. No, it's already happened. So you have no choice but to tip it back, you know, in your direction. Tip the scales in the direction of sanity. Because if you don't put your weight, full weight, towards sanity right now, the scales will go towards insanity very badly. So you literally have to put all your weight on the scale. You know, some people, they want to put one foot on the platform and one foot on the train. At this time, that's not possible because the train is moving very fast right now. So you have to decide which, are you going to be on the platform or are you going to be on the train? In other words, make a decision. Are you going to fish or cut bait? You know, one or the other. The tipping has already happened. So if you don't put your full weight towards sanity, the tipping will most definitely, you will slide into the abyss. And we've been warned about this time. And these techniques, they're not going to enlighten you just like that or anything, but what they do is they will help you. It's like a kind of a workout where you get in spiritual shape, where then you can take pragmatic, practical steps. For instance, by admitting, you know what, my attempt to be enlightened under these circumstances was really, for me, I say, was really an attempt to be special, have a special enlightenment, better than others. And I recognize that in it, for the folly that it is, actually. And I repented of it and said, you know what? That's stupid. You know, forget it. So if you leave this situation, you obviously leave behind the quote-unquote opportunity to reach enlightenment under very difficult circumstances. And so that's like a major hang-up that I discovered. Thinking like, oh no, I don't. If I leave this place, I'll miss my opportunity to prove that I had a tougher time to be enlightened than others. But of course, enlightenment is enlightenment. The Holy Spirit's perception is the same no matter how you get to it. There's no ranking in reality. There's no ranks. There's no hierarchy in reality. There's no special enlightenment in reality. So it's just a folly. It's folly. It's stupidity. It's arrogance, you know, to do that. So seeing this, you say, it's better than to leave the situation, take refuge in a place that's easier to attain enlightenment, to accept the Holy Spirit's vision, perception of what, spell it, steady perception of effortless, lovely loveliness. It's, the easier you get to it, the better, because the faster, the better. Right now, the world circumstances are getting way too difficult, actually. Way too difficult, getting crazy. And, you know, it's not time to be a show-off, you know. I have the tendency to be a show-off that way. Like, I can do it under the toughest circumstances. That's just, you know, stupidity. So there's an example of how you can, using honesty and humility and repentance, find out what's binding you to the situation. And using these techniques, you keep your mind focused so you can do that. See, it's too late for this. In other words, your focus remains intact. I'm focused on steady perception of effortless lovely loveliness. That is salvation. That is the solution of the continuity problem. And I'm rejecting insanity. Home by making this world so-called a better home than reality. I reject that entirely. See, and then that helps then see what's binding me here. What's causing the problem? Oh, I'm trying to succeed under very difficult circumstances, and that's an ego trip. The ego tricks us into that, saying, hey, you'll be even better than others if you succeed under these difficult circumstances. So that it is an ego trip. It's a trap leveraged because of our continuity fear. So we'll see what tomorrow brings. I just want to pass this on, that easing into technique, just ease into technique. Just like it's putting your toe in the water and you say, oh, that water's not so bad. At some point you have to do it. You have to do it. Just this dialogue and thinking is not enough. It's never enough, but right now we're out of time. We're out of time. We cannot just keep doing that, you know, during these times, because it is. Most people don't realize what's happened here. It's already happened. They don't get it. But talking about it specifically is not going to help. So, just whenever something comes up for you, just say, ah, you're too late. You're too late for me. For me, you're too late. I can't speak for others, but for me, you arrived too late. I'm sorry, too late. Too late to have any influence on me. You're too late to have any influence on me. Too late. And then whatever you see, and there's plenty that can be seen, you will just say, ah, that's too late. You're too late. I'm not bothered by the slightest bit. You're too late. It's a miracle technique. So, any teacher, I think, now to be effective, to be helpful in pointing us towards the Holy Spirit's remedy, is going to need to just use technique like this, you know, instead of talk. You can't talk anymore. And that puts the pressure on all of us, actually. It does, which is a good thing. You know, we need the pressure now. We need tough love right now. We really need it. So, I pray that the tough love comes, and we are just told, look, this you have to actually practice. Now, this has been reflected in our outer circumstances. For instance, for me, I'm starting to do stationary bicycle work, you know, every day, and just saying, hey, you know, you can't just think your way to being fit. You have to actually do the exercises to be fit. And of course, we don't like that. We keep thinking there should be a way to just think your way fit, but there really isn't, from our standpoint here. So, have to actually do the exercises. And okay, you know, well, whatever. Let's get to it. Let's get to it. And it's that attitude. You don't have to love it. You know, the ego tells you all these parameters that you have to follow, meet, criteria you have to meet, and parameters to follow. Nah, it's all nonsense. It's all nonsense. The ego's lying as always. You just do it. You just do it. You don't have to like it. You just find a way to get through it. Just do it. Find a way to get through it. That's all. Just like the cycling. I don't like it. I just try to find my way to keep myself motivated. That's all. I don't like exercising at all, but you just have to find ways to stay motivated. Today, there's going to be a video up. Maybe it's already posted. Maybe it posted before this one. You saw it as the driving. And just said, hey, let's just use this time, let's use this opportunity, motivation. You have to keep your motivation going and use technique. Find a technique, use a technique. Lovely loveliness is a great technique, extraordinary technique, because the ego can give you drugs to see loveliness or take you on beautiful places. Ah, let's go to Hawaii, you'll see loveliness, okay. But the Holy Spirit shows you lovely loveliness, which drugs and all the drugs in the world can't show you that. And we say, why, what's lovely loveliness? And yet there's something about that double term like that that resonates very strongly. like a miracle. I'm not seeing the loveliness of this thing. I'm seeing the lovely loveliness of this thing, of all things, the lovely loveliness of it. And thereby you're able to differentiate between those who are putting on a show of, oh, I'm so lovely, I can teach you to see loveliness. And there are many like that in those who are actually seeing lovely loveliness. You know, just an immeasurable difference, actually. Difference between the ego and the Holy Spirit, plain and simple. So, steady perception, effortless, lovely, loveliness, a very powerful technique, acronym. And a reminder, wherever you are, I'm lost, I'm under a spell. Oh, spell, S-P-E-L-L, steady perception of effortless, lovely, loveliness. Oh yeah, that's the answer. See, and then right away, you're no longer lost. Just like that. Takes about a couple seconds, and suddenly you're right back in the driver's seat. In fact, you're always in the driver's seat, but you get distracted and you forget that you are. And you can wander for eons in this distraction, or you can just use this technique, spell technique, and be right in a matter of seconds, you realize, oh, I'm in the driver's seat. Okay, what do I need to remember? Oh yeah, insanity doesn't work. Insanity is constantly trying to hook me, and I don't want to be hooked. The Holy Spirit doesn't want that for me. I don't want it for myself. Holy Spirit doesn't want it for me. Therefore, let's drop that. So I am, you know, I'm dismayed as far as looking at the world and the lack of teaching, those who are bringing the stuff, the technique, really. It's like, wow. They're just talking about personality stuff. It's like, that's way too late for that stuff. It's not escape velocity. You know, let's talk about the personality and the spiritual thing and the miracle, blah, blah, blah. Ah, no. Spell it. S-P-E-L. That's what we need. We need steady perception of effortless, lovely, loveliness. And it's too late for everything else. It's too late for everything else. It's too late for everything else. It's too late for all dialogue. It's too late for all dialogue. It's too late for failure. It's too late for time. It's too late for the ego. It's too late for everything. Everything other than the Holy Spirit's steady perception of effortless, lovely, loveliness. It's too late for everything else. Too late. It's too late. Just, that's it, you know. That's where you have to be right now. If you want to succeed, you have to be in that, put yourself in the driver's seat. Spell puts you in the driver's seat, and then from there you affirm you're in the driver's seat by saying it's too late for all this stuff. So one, I'm in the driver's seat, and now I'm affirming that and putting it to use, putting that realization to use. Those two techniques is a 1-2 punch, 1-2 punch, and you can do a 1-2-3, lovely loveliness, double down on that, and that just disarms the ego right there. It can't compete with that. It can't compete with that. It wants to keep you shallow and say, no, I'm just looking for loveliness. No, you say, no, the Holy Spirit gives me lovely loveliness. And the ego just, yeah, shuts it up. So a 1-2-3 punch. Where am I? In the driver's seat, the spell technique. What is my, how do I use this realization? So it's too late for everything else. It's too late for failure. It's too late for delay. It's too late for insanity. It's too late for insanity. And then I see now lovely loveliness. You know, it's too late for loveliness. I have, you know, I'm seeing lovely loveliness now. I'm seeing lovely loveliness. Steady, I see steady perception of everless lovely loveliness. So 1-2, 1-2, 1-2 kind of punch type of thing, right? You go back to the spell. You locate where you're at in the driver's seat. Affirm that it's too late for everything else, and then reaffirm that you're in the driver's seat because you're seeing lovely loveliness. That's what the Holy Spirit has for you. and that just knocks everything else out. So all we need is a teacher that can stay on this. You know, that's all we need. Someone who's really 100% on point with this, 100%. And then the rest of us who can get that, but just need the reassurance that this is okay, then can get with it to a very strong extent also. But I believe you need a nucleus to the situation. Just like this comet coming in has a nucleus. Well, we need a guru that has a nucleus, a true guru who just says, this is what you must do right now, and be completely with it in their own being. I can say it here, but I can't implement it in various situations that people are so resistant to it. But the guru has no such problem. And then you say, I can do that too. Okay, so something has to break the ice right now. And then others will say, oh, okay, this is happening now. This is now happening. So we need this to come along at the same time that we become aware that this comet is coming through visual identification here on Earth. At the same time, we need another nucleus that says, these affirmations, this 1-2 punch, is exactly what is needed. And I give full authority to do that. I give full blessing to do that right now. And to back us up, have our backs, you know, just say, no, I got your back on this. I absolutely have your back on this. So the world desperately needs that type of situation right now, I'm telling you. So I'm all for it. All for that. But again, we need the authority. We need someone that people recognize their authority and say, wow, I can't mess with them. They're too adamant. They're too certain. They're too flawlessly certain about it. I just can't, you know, I cannot push on them. The ego just doesn't work there. And then the rest of us can breathe this huge sigh of relief, you know, that just like, wow, somebody's got our back. So if they want to criticize us for doing it, they have to criticize the guru. You see what I'm saying? But without a guru here in the world, I find this too difficult. It's just people just, you know, say, I don't see anybody here, you know, helping you, backing you up. You must be nuts. So, let us pray that such a guru shows up now. Man, piece of cake right now for us, piece of cake. All right, let's keep going with this and see what tomorrow brings. That's it for this one.